Omega-3s can really do wonders if you want to lower your creatinine levels. And that's a fact. Actually, there are very few home remedies that can really help kidney patients in all the stages. And in my experience, omega-3 fatty acids are among the few that really works. My name is Catherine and I've been working with kidney disease patients for 7 years. I've seen people getting back their kidney function with an improved diet and lifestyle, and many of them are using omega-3s. And if you are new here in 00 Kidney, subscribe now and click the notification bell so you're not missing my updates. But before you start taking omega-3s, I want you to know that there could also be dangers connected to the use of this supplement many people are not aware of. Not all brands are safe for people with kidney disease, okay? And well, I've seen recommendations for the dosages of omega-3s all over the place, especially here on YouTube. So I know for sure that very few people get the right dosage. Now, the good part is that as soon as you start getting omega-3s the right way, you'll notice it immediately. For example, on your mood, because omega-3s fight depression. But also if you suffer from itchy skin as a complication of CKD, yes, omega-3 can alleviate it. And you'll see a difference in your creatinine levels too. Now, to get these benefits, just eating fish once in a while or guzzling a couple of pills is not enough. Also, not all omega-3 brands are the same. Some oils are better than others for protection against kidney disease. For example, the omega-3s you may be taking may contain too few DHA or EPA to be effective. Or it can be downright unhealthy for you if it's made from certain oils. Another thing even doctors get wrong is forgetting to tell people that they need to limit their omega-6 intake to get benefits from omega-3s. So, DHA, EPA, omega-3s, omega-6, all these may sound confusing, right? This is why today, I'm presenting you the complete guide to omega-3 fatty acid supplementation for people with kidney disease. We are going to see the best way to get enough omega-3s, to get a tangible result, the correct dosages, how to get omega-3s from food, and we'll also see how to choose the right supplement for you. Okay, let's start immediately. Here's why I think people with kidney disease should take omega-3s. Some of the proven benefits of a diet rich in omega-3s include better mental health and reduced risk for depression. And don't underestimate this benefit. People suffering from depression are almost always going to get worse outcomes from chronic diseases. Studies indicate that people who consume omega-3s regularly are less likely to be depressed. But also, when people with depression or anxiety start taking omega-3 supplements, their symptoms improve almost immediately. Omega-3s can fight autoimmune diseases. These include type 1 diabetes, but also lupus, arthritis, and even IgA nephropathy. IgA nephropathy is an autoimmune kidney disorder that has no cure. Omega-3s can slow down its progression. The omega-3 fatty acids in fish oil prevent inflammation in the kidney, alright? And this slows down the progression of kidney disease. Let's notice that this mechanism works for people with chronic kidney disease caused by other pathologies too, because omega-3s can fight inflammation. Chronic kidney disease has a very important inflammatory component. In short, inflammation actively damages your kidneys. Omega-3 fatty acids can reduce the production of molecules and substances linked to inflammation, okay? This slows down the progression of the disease and can actually lower your creatinine levels. But it's not all. Omega-3s can improve all the main risk factors for kidney disease, heart disease, and metabolic syndrome. These include blood pressure, inflammation, as we have seen, but even insulin resistance, and this is incredibly important for people with type 2 diabetes. And this home remedy can also help uremic pruritus, the itchy skin caused by kidney disease. More about this in a moment. Now, if this seems too good to be true, double check the studies I'm referring to if you want. The links you can see in my slides are also in the description. And when you're done, get back here because there is more that you need to know about omega-3s. First of all, not all sources of omega-3s are going to give you these benefits, okay? Because there is fish oil supplements, omega-3 supplements, animal sources of omega-3s, there is liver oils, there is omega-6. Some of these are good and some are bad for you, okay? So let's see why. There are several sources of omega-3 fatty acids we should consider. Very first one is fatty fish. It's the best way to get omega-3s, but it's not always enough. Mackerel, herring, sardines, anchovies, salmon are all good sources of omega-3s, and you should definitely include them in your diet. Eating them 2 or 3 times per week would be best. Now, in a renal diet, you should also limit protein, and these fishes are very rich in protein, so it's unlikely that you will be able to get all the omega-3s that you need just from the diet. Now, omega-3s can be found in plants too. Chia seeds, flax seeds, and walnuts are all good sources, but we should also consider that it is not the same omega-3s we can find in fishes, okay? There are 3 main types of omega-3 fatty acids: ALA, EPA, and DHA. ALA is found in plants and it's not the active form, meaning that it can help you a little bit, but your body is not going to use all of it, okay? EPA and DHA are a lot better for you. They're what you can find in fatty fish and supplements. EPA fights inflammation and DHA is for brain health. This is what you want, okay? Now, talking about supplements, there are thousands of different brands and types of omega-3s you can find. How to find the right one? Omega-3 dietary supplements include fish oil, krill oil, cod liver oil, halibut liver oil, algal oil. These are totally different things, okay? Fish oil supplements are the most used and the most researched. This is what you want. And absolutely avoid supplements containing cod liver oil and halibut liver oil. Okay? These fish liver oils contain large amounts of vitamin A. It's dangerous for people with kidney disease because it can accumulate and become toxic. So double check anything you may be already taking and stop taking it if it contains these two, okay? Krill oil may be a good choice too, but it's less accessible and pricier than regular fish oil. Also, there are less studies on it. Algal oil is an interesting choice for vegetarians, but while algae oils do contain large amounts of brain-boosting DHA, most don't contain any EPA fatty acids at all. So, better stick to fish oil unless you have to keep your diet vegan or vegetarian. To recap, prefer fish oil supplements and absolutely avoid liver oil. Now, to find the right brands of fish oil supplement, you should consider two things: the EPA and DHA content and the fish they're getting the oil from. This is an easy way to find the best brands. So look at the label and see how much EPA and DHA the supplement you're buying contains. Okay. An omega-3 fish oil supplement is most effective when it contains high concentrations of EPA and DHA rich fish oil. Unfortunately, common fish oil supplements can contain as little as 8% of active DHA and EPA, and instead include inferior fish oil that may not be beneficial to your health. And choose a brand that tells you where they're getting the fish oil. Choose fish oil that is derived from wild, cold water fish that are low on the food chain, such as sardines and anchovies. Avoid fish oils that are sourced from bottom feeders, scavengers, or farm-raised fish. Now, maybe the most important thing when starting supplementing with omega-3 fatty acid is getting the correct dosage, but this may be not always easy. Here's why. So, how much EPA and DHA should you take to get the benefits? While this may seem like a simple question, the answer can actually be quite complicated. Now, in this slide, we can see what the dosages are for several conditions that can be treated with omega-3s. I'll show you here. As I was saying, we should care about how much EPA and DHA we get daily. The recommendation for healthy adults is a minimum of 250 to 500 milligrams combined EPA and DHA each day, okay? This is the bare minimum, okay? Everyone should get this quantity of omega-3s from their diet. If you don't get at least this quantity, you can experience symptoms like fatigue, poor memory, dry skin, heart problems, mood swings or depression, and poor circulation. So if you feel like you're not getting enough omega-3s from your diet because you don't eat fish every day, start with this dosage. And actually, it is quite difficult for a kidney patient to get enough omega-3s from the diet because of the protein. And with most brands, you may just be needing one or two pills per day to get this quantity. Obviously, talk to your doctor, but this dosage is basically safe for everyone. Now, you may see here that I'm listing dosages for specific pathologies. These are the results of the most recent studies on omega-3s. Most of the studies on heart disease and high blood pressure found out that the right dosage was 1000 milligrams of combined EPA and DHA per day. People with high triglycerides got better results with dosages ranging between 2000 and 4000 milligrams per day. Now, there is a very interesting study on people in the advanced stages of kidney disease who were treated with a higher dose of omega-3s. We're talking about 4000 milligrams of combined EPA and DHA per day. And while the results of this study are really encouraging, this is more than the FDA considers safe, alright? So, you obviously will need to be followed by your doctor to get this much omega-3s per day. And the same applies to people suffering from IgA nephropathy. Again, the sources of these studies are in the description, so you can read them. Or maybe print them and show the results to your doctor. Now, my advice here is to start with lowest dosage, especially if you don't get enough omega-3s from your diet. See how it makes you feel, all right? Chances are that if you are not taking omega-3s already, minimum dosage will already make a big difference. And that's also the safest dosage. The more the dosage, the more the side effects. Let's see why. So, what side effects we should consider for omega-3s? According to the Food and Drug Administration, taking up to 3,000 milligrams of combined EPA and DHA per day from supplements is safe, but there could be some mild side effects even at low dosage. Upset stomach, heartburn, or diarrhea may be experienced in some cases. Not really common actually, especially if you take pills on a full stomach, which I strongly recommend. Now, the only real problem worth mentioning is the blood thinning effects of omega-3s. This usually happens with higher doses, so speak to your doctor if you have a bleeding disorder or are taking blood thinning medications like aspirin or warfarin. The other interaction is with medications for high blood pressure. Omega-3s will help you lowering your blood pressure, and that's good, but you should get monitored by your doctor when you start this supplement because there's the chance of your blood pressure going too low. That will be a good thing actually, because your doctor could then lower your dose of high blood pressure medications, and that will be really good. Now, a very important thing we should consider is the omega-6 to omega-3 ratio. Omega-6 fatty acids are types of fats contained in many oils. They're not really healthy, especially because the typical Western diet contains around 10 times more omega-6 than omega-3s. And too much omega-6 can raise your blood pressure, lead to blood clots that can cause heart attack and stroke, and cause your body to retain water. So, rather than just taking omega-3s, also reduce your intake of omega-6, okay? Sources of omega-6 include safflower oil, sunflower oil, corn oil, soybean oil, sunflower seeds, walnuts, pumpkin seeds. Many of these oils are used in processed foods and in unhealthy ways of cooking. They're not healthy choices. Now, too many people consume a lot of these sources of omega-6 and too few omega-3s. The problem is that they compete for the same receptors, all right? This means that eating too many foods rich or cooked in these oils will prevent your body from absorbing the omega-3s you need. And this is just another reason to avoid processed foods and junk foods in general. Okay guys, I think you should have all the info to get the best from a home remedy as powerful as omega-3s now. But if you have any doubt, feel free to ask in comment section. I always try to answer as much comments as I can. This is all for today. See you next time and thank you for watching.